I have a question to ask you. Do rabbits have long or short tails? Short. Well, now they do. But I'll tell you something. Long ago, this is a long time ago, rabbits had very, very long tails. Oh yeah, it's a long time ago. This is when your great, 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 great grandmothers were little girls. This is a long time ago. This is when stones were soft. This is when animals weren't quite ready yet. The rabbit and the dog were best of friends. They were always together. They would have breakfast together, lunch together, supper together. Best of friends. One morning they were having breakfast together when Anansi came by. Now, Anansi was rather jealous of the friendship between the dog and the rabbit. Nobody here is jealous, right? Oh, good, good, good. Don't be jealous. Well, Anansi was jealous, and he wanted to start some trouble between these two friends. The dog saw Anansi first. The dog said, "Anansi, what are you doing up so early? You never get up before 12 o'clock. Anansi said, "Well, I wanted to get up early this morning, you see, for there was a boat leaving. And the boat is going to the magical island." "The magical island? I've always wanted to go to the magical island," said the dog. "Well, you can't go." "Why not?" "You don't have any horns. The only animals allowed on the boat are animals with horns. You can't go." "But I want to go on the boat. I want to go on the boat. I want to go on the boat," said the dog. "You can't go. You don't have any horns." The dog looked at the rabbit and said, "But I want to go on the boat. I want to go on the boat. I want to go on the boat." "You heard what Anansi said. We don't have any horns. We can't get on that boat." Anansi knew he had planted the seeds of trouble. So Anansi went back into the woods to his home. The dog said, "But I want to go on the boat." The rabbit thought for a moment and said, "Ooh, ooh, ooh, I have an idea. Let's go in the woods. We'll each get two long sticks and a couple of leaves. We'll poke the sticks up through the holes in the leaves. We'll get some vines and we'll tie the sticks off. We'll make headpieces like bonnets. And once we place them on our heads, those sticks will be poking up in the air like that. It'll make us look just as if we have horns." And that's just what they did. They both went into the woods, each found two long sticks. They got a couple of leaves. They poked the sticks up through the holes in the leaves. They got some vines and they tied the sticks off. They made beautiful headpieces like bonnets. But you see, the headpieces that they made were rather heavy. And they had to help one another place them on each other's heads. So dog said, "Rabbit, you help me put mine on and I'll help you." And the rabbit agreed. He picked up the dog's headpiece and he placed it on the dog's head. Dog took those vines, he tied a nice knot under his chin. And then the dog went over to the water to look at his reflection. And with those sticks poking up like that, it made him look just as if he had horns. And he looked at his reflection in the water. The dog said, "I look nice, I look nice, I look nice." "Yeah, you look nice," said the rabbit, "but help me put mine on. Wait a minute, I'm looking at myself. I look nice, I look nice, I look nice. Will you help me?" Well, just then, the boat started to leave. The dog said, "Oop, I gotta go, goodbye." And off he went. The rabbit said, "But wait, but wait, but wait for me." And the dog ran. And he got right in line with all those animals with horns. And that dog got right on that boat. Who can tell me some names of animals with horns? A deer, a moose, yes, a yak, an ox, a wildebeest, a giraffe, a caribou, and a gazelle, and a cow, and a buffalo. And all those animals with horns are getting right on that boat. And that dog with his phony horns, he got on that boat too. The rabbit looked The rabbit was angry, and the boat started to sail away. When the rabbit noticed a little hill next to the water, he quickly ran over to that hill, and as that boat was sailing by, the rabbit called out, "Captain! Captain! One of your passengers has no horns!" The dog went over to the captain and said, "Captain, did you hear what he said? He said, turn the boat to the left, to the left." The captain, he turned that boat to the left, to the left. The rabbit, he ran over to the next hill and he called out, "Captain, captain, one of your passengers has no horns." And once again, the dog went over to the captain and said, he said, turn the boat to the right, to the right. And the captain, he turned that boat to the right, to the right. The rabbit looked, there was only one hill left. He ran to the top of that hill and he called out in a mighty voice, "And I need your help." "Captain, captain, one of your passengers has no horns." And the wind took those words across the water, over the stern of that boat, right to the captain's ears. And the captain said, "One of my passengers has no horns. Trim the sail, drop the anchor, stop the boat, and line up." And all those animals lined up. And that captain, he walked over to the buffalo, and the yak, and the ox, and the goat, and the wildebeest, and the gazelle, and the elk, and the deer, and the cow, and the giraffe, and the unicorn. And he was getting closer and closer to the dog. The dog knew he was going to get caught. The dog quickly jumped over the side of that boat and started doing the doggy paddle. Whoosh, 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 whoosh. The rabbit looked. He saw the redness in the dog's eyes, and that rabbit, he lit on out. Woof. And as he ran, his long tail flopped, and he ran, and his long tail flopped, and he ran, and his long tail flopped, as the dog was doing the doggy paddle. Whoosh, 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 until he got to the sandy beach, where he shook himself dry and lit out after that rabbit. Now the rabbit ran, and his long tail flopped, and the dog was gaining. And the rabbit ran, and his long tail flopped, and the dog was gaining. And the rabbit ran, and his long tail flopped, and the dog was gaining and gaining and gaining. Finally, the rabbit reached the safety of its home, and he jumped down that rabbit hole. But he didn't have enough time to pull down that long, bushy, beautiful tail. And the dog came right up behind him and went, "Ow!" and bit the rabbit's tail right off. And ever since that day, rabbits have short little tails, and dogs are always chasing them. Yes, they are.